All right, this is my TCI EZ-TCU transmission controller, and this is going to control my 4l60-e transmission. Now, I don't know how many parts I'm going to do this. I'm going to actually do it in just one part, but you're also going to need this throttle position cable, and you can actually get them both as a kit. I got it online and got the wire going straight across along the bottom, and it hooks up right there where the normal transmission cable goes to on the like the 700R4 and stuff like that. And then you run the wire straight over here to the bottom, and this is for my hydraulic carburetor. See, and what happens is when you step on the throttle, it pulls the cable, and over here when I pull the cable, kind of hard to see, it's weird. Every time I open the throttle and I let go, hit the throttle, and that tells the transmission like where the position of the throttle is at, and it helps it downshift, upshift, and regulates the pressure inside. That's one that's hooked up. Now, actually, you know what? I'm actually gonna mount this right here. Or maybe up here. Yeah, right there. I might just mount it right there. Drill a couple of holes, or maybe some self-tapping screws or something like that. Then, this, let me see. There goes the box. You can actually control the shift points and some other stuff. This is the computer. I haven't decided yet, but I might put it over here too on the firewall as well, maybe back here somewhere. I'm gonna play with it, but I'll show you guys where I mounted it. And then let me see, let me get this out, hopefully. Ooh, wow, and there goes the wire harness. And I'm gonna make videos on showing where all these wires are gonna get all hooked up. Alright. Alright, here I'm gonna show that I decided to go with double-sided tape. Let's peel these suckers up. Oh, it's so hard to get them started. Come on. Alright, let me peel them first. I got them started. So there goes one, two, three. Let's see. Let's see, kind of wind it like maybe as far back, I think. Don't know why, but I feel comfortable with a bit back here. There you go. It's 3M double sided tape. It's pretty strong stuff. I cleaned the wall a little bit, get all the dust off of this side and the other side too. Use a little bit of rubbing alcohol to get it really nice and clean and grease free. So hopefully that'll stay there for a while. Hopefully. Easier than drilling a bunch of holes. Alright, let's try the next box. That'll probably be right next to it somewhere. Alright, let me get the other box ready. Alright, here goes the beginning of the wiring. You can see it looks like a, I don't know how to do this. Oh, I'll put it on the floor, I guess. Let me see. Alright, so that's one of the wiring. It also has that one. I think these are all the little plugs. That's going to go on there. Then I have this one here. Haven't figured it out yet. It's a communication cable. And read this book. It's a freaking book. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm going to go ahead and read this book. And, this got to be, 15, 20 pages maybe? Shoot. And every time I put a wire in, I'll just show it. Looking at the cable, I noticed that everything seems to be... Oh man, I don't know. I can't see it. It's got a bunch of labels. Let's see. This one says flash enable. What does this one say? TCC apply, traction control. I'm sorry, torque converter control. Torque converter. Lockup, something like that. Economy performance. Can link. Handheld. I mean, it's so short. I don't know how that's going to work. It says the negative cable goes straight to the battery and don't splice it. So it has to go straight to the negative battery. I guess if you ground it to the chassis or if you ground it to any other stuff, it'll give you like a humming when you turn the radio on. No interfere. Battery position, no splicing. So I got a battery. It's got to go straight to the positive and straight to the negative. And there's a pink one here. And that's 12 volt switched. Okay. This one here is speedometer control unit. Yeah, you go. I need to figure out if that's going straight to the tranny or if that's going to the dash. And there's more labels down here. That's for the throttle position cable. I think this one's the one that's gonna go over here. Yeah, it fits right in there. All right. Let me figure out more of this wiring and come back. I'm looking through this wiring harness. There are quite a few wires that is not going to be used. There are some that will be used, but like for example, there's one that says can link. I won't be using that one. There's one that's called economy performance. You got to hook it up to a ground switch, and that's to make the tranny just give you economy, save fuel mileage. But there's no way I'm going to get fuel mileage out of this thing. TCC applied, you can connect that to a ground switch as well, and what that'll do is connect the converter lockup, so you can turn it on whenever you want, or leave it disconnected, and it'll come on and off automatically without your input. But that's, you know, I'm not going to use that either. I'll let it do it automatically. So these wires I won't be using. The only wires that you will be mostly be using are these two. This one goes to the tranny, the big fat one, and this other one goes to the output shaft speed, and this one goes to the back of the tranny. So these are the only two that are going to stay on the outside. Everything else is going to go to the inside of the cab. This one, if you got a speedometer, you plug this into your speedometer. I'm going to get one later on. And then, this one also stays on the outside. The throttle cable. And this other one for the RPM. But one thing I noticed when I read it, I have a coil, and they absolutely do not want you to hook it up to the coil. They just keep saying about an ignition box. So I might have to get a CD ignition box, because it needs to read the speed at the speed engine, the engine of the speed of the engine. I don't know what I'm gonna do about that right now, but I might have to add up one of those ignition boxes just so that this can work properly. And then these wires, they're gonna stay on the outside because they have to go straight to the battery. 12 volt switch, battery negative. Yeah, there's a couple of here. They're gonna stay outside. Let's see. And on the paperwork, I did read it. It does tell you what each one does, you know, for the tags. 12 volt switch, you know, throttle position cable. It tells you everything in detail. It didn't take long at all for me to understand it. And then right here is the installation sequence. It tells you to hook up the tranny and the output shaft speed. And then after that, get to the RPM signal. Then after that, to the throttle position. Then after that, to the speedometer. And it just goes down the line. So, this big plug, I screwed it on here, the computer, and right here is the throttle position sensor. So, let's see. Hopefully I can just clean it home. Need to keep it away from the exhaust header. Here's a lot of stuff that I'm not going to use. From the EZ-TCU, as I keep reading on, this orange one. This goes to, like, let's say if you have a analog speedometer, you will have to put a box or connect this to a box. I guess it's called like a, what is that stupid thing called? It's a square wave to drive electronic speedometer. So, but I'm not going to have a speedometer. I'm going to use my GPS as a speedometer. So I'm not going to use that. This one is speedometer control unit. Like I said, I'm going to use a GPS on my phone. But now I'm not going to have a speedometer. This one is for a CAN link. I'm not going to be using this one either. This one, flash enable. I'm not going to use it. But it says make sure it doesn't get grounded. So it'll make the transmission not work. So I just put a tape on the end of it. Make sure it doesn't ground. This one is a manual shift. I'm not gonna use that either. And you got another one, 12 volt switched. Yeah, I'm gonna use that. So I'm gonna wire in the back of all this, in the background here, and I got a hole back here, so I'm gonna bring that inside the cab. Then I got this one. This is through the throttle position sensor. That one is gonna go right here. I gotta route it. And then it got the positive and the negative. That's going to go straight to the battery. And that's about it, really. I mean, so I'm only using 1, 2, 3 wires. 4 for the throttle position sensor. Then you got to hook it up to the RPM, which is going to go right to my digital box. This wire here, the gray one, is for the RPM. And then that's it, really. I mean, except for the big one that goes to the transmission and to the speedometer to the back of the tranny. What I'm going to do is I'm going to roll this up and just pack it in here somewhere, you know. I'm not going to cut it or splice it, so I'm just going to leave it nice and rolled up there. I'll be back. Instructions are said to use. The female end of the buck connector. And that's the tach in RPM module. This is the one that goes to the RPM for the tach on the box. So, and the kit came with that plug. So I went ahead and spliced it into the gray wire in my digital box. And now I'm going to plug in the female part of this. So I got the gray wire in there, and here's this one. I need to figure out a way on how to roll this. Right now I'm hooking up the 1 to the throttle position sensor. Which I think I screwed up. Thank you. some kind of connector. Now, this video I'm going to show the transfer case. I had a guy named Michael, a subscriber, and he was asking about it. He wanted to see what it looks like. There's the transfer case. This one is the, I don't know if you can see it, 243C. Now, a friend of mine told me that he had a 241C. This 243 is electronically controlled. The one that he's going to give me is a 241C, and it's manual. I don't have to hook up any electronics to it whatsoever. But it's identical in size. So this one, when I put it in, was very, very tight right here. It actually, I have less than a quarter inch between the transfer case and the back of this torsion bar support. And I did have to raise it up all the way up against the body, because I don't have any spacers. I don't have any, see, it's still stock. I don't have any spacers here, so I wanted to keep it low. And when I raised it up, touching the body, I just barely cleared the bottom also. But either way, it fit, it worked. The dry shaft, I just had it done today. This is the stock drive shaft. Now, I don't know if it's going to be strong enough to hold it. I think the engine is going to be making like 350 horsepower, 300, maybe 375, something like that. But the back part, I kept it. He just put some new bushings and bearings inside of it. He put brand new ones on there. And then he painted. But the front end right here, oh boy, okay, but the front part of the drive shaft, that the yoke came out of the Suburban. See, this one came out of the Suburban. Now, he put a different kind of U-joint right here, and this U-joint is actually greasable. So that's a good thing. I can keep that sucker greased up. But you take it to your local drive shaft specialist, and they can actually make this for you. So this is actually going to the drive shaft, U-joint. Holy shit. Now it blew my mind. I can't remember what this is called here. But anyway, this came out of the drive shaft out of the Suburban. As you can see, he put this special here. This part right here is still part of the Nissan. They actually have the same size holes, but he changed the cups. This cup is for the Nissan, and this cup is for the Suburban. So he aimed to change. He made a little hybrid deal going on there, but it works. And we ended up cutting the drive shaft 4 inches. And then he re-welded it. You can see it. I don't know if you can see it, but he re-welded and balanced it. So right now you can see it's spinning the whole thing. Well, like I said, I don't know if it's going to be strong enough. Oh my god, I was videotaping upside down. Here's one thing that the instructions do not explain, is that when you have a 4x4, this connection is the one that goes to the output shaft speed. Okay, this is the connector that came with it, but the 4l60-e does not have a speed sensor for the four-wheel drive. It's on the transfer case. But if you look at this transfer case here, let me get this thing here. You see, it doesn't work. It doesn't, let me get a better view here. It's completely different. Let me see. So this little bag came in the kit, and it has all these little stuff on there. It's got these four little connectors that goes to this plug, and then you have these two bigger ones that goes to this connector. This is the one that connects to the transfer case. See that one? This is the one that fits right in there. Oop. Got a little groove, so you gotta match it up. See, that's the one that goes right in there. But it didn't explain to that. It didn't explain it in the instructions. So, and I have two books in there. I read it front to back and didn't say. So, I cut the, where did it go? So I cut this one off. And now I'm going to wire up this one. With these two connections here. But first, where did it go? Oh, it's over here. There you go. Okay. But you got to put these two little insulators first on the wire. And this wire right here. So you put those green little insulators inside. Let's see. And then you can splice the wire. No, let me go back over here. Alright, so you put the green insulators inside, then splice the wire. And then you connect these two larger ones. And I have to look, but I think it might be just a certain one way that it goes inside there. Let me go ahead. I need my two hands, so I'm going to go ahead and do this, and I'll show you. So what I ended up doing, I took the old harness that was hooked up to the Suburban, and I found the speedometer cable connection hookup, and I just spliced it into it. No, it took me like 2 minutes, you know. Yeah. This way I have the other one as a spare, just in case this ever breaks. If I have it, I might as well use it. And then I wire it up. I have it hooked up. Let's see. Transmission one is hooked up over there. Let's hook up under the hood. Those are the only two wires that's going to be under the engine. I mean, under the tranny, under the car, so the rest is going to be at the engine. Okay, let's see for the pink wire right here. I'm just going to run it into one of these upper fuses up here. Just the way I have it for the tach and, shoot, I forgot what the other red wire is for. Just going to run it up, around. And tap it into one of these other fuses, and that'll give me my key on for the EZU, the TCU, EZ-TCU. Let me go ahead and do that real quick. There you go. Got it all tucked in there. Pull the fuse out, just wrapped it around the top one, and then so it's nice and steady there. So here what I did, I got this quicksilver, it's for a 4-speed, 700 R4 BMW. I'm sorry, B&M BMW. And then I put a plate on here. Normally got a big hole, so I just put a sheet metal. It's actually pretty nice and strong on there. Drilled the four holes, bolted underneath, and I just used some self-tapping screws. And that's what I did for the shifter. Right now I'm gonna mark where to drill my hole over here somewhere so I could run the cable for the shifter part. Yeah, see how that goes.
Yeah.